Greetings and welcome. We are in the final four now of the Avrotech Intel Classic. My name is Nick Plott, also known as Tasteless, and I am very pumped to be casting these games today. We only have one round. It's going to be Shuttle against Jadong. And I have to say right off the bat, this is going to be pretty tough for Shuttle. Jadong is just so strong. I don't know who can stop him. That doesn't mean Shuttle is incapable of achieving such a feat, but it's going to be very tough for him. I know he's been training nonstop this entire week for this moment. And hopefully he can perform a little bit better than he did in the Pro League not long ago. Our map lineup is going to be Katrina first, Blue Storm second, and then third will be Othello, fourth Colosseum, and fifth will be Katrina. The maps which the players chose to exclude, we do allow each player to discard one map. A Shuttle chose to discard Andromeda, and Jadong chose to discard Hills of Storm, which I believe is also known as Wuthering Heights. The maps were randomly shuffled at this moment, and again, this is going to be a best of five. Shuttle, the only player to make it this far without being seeded halfway through the tournament. We did take the better players by rank. We did put them ahead in the tournament, while the lesser-known players or less accomplished players, we put them in the 128th phase of the tournament. So only Shuttle has made it this far. The other three have all managed to... they were all seated here. So Shuttle, representing the newer scene of Korean professional gamers, we're certainly going to see a lot more of this guy in the future. He's clearly very strong. Making it to the final four of a 128-person tournament is no small feat. Our other players, who we will be broadcasting, or at least we'll be watching the games, next week, it's going to be Backo versus Stork. Backo versus Flash. Backo beats Stork. And I think that's going to be a pretty cool match. So the winner of this does move on to the final. Again, thank you to our sponsors at Intel. Without this, it would not be possible. Thank you to our pro gamers for taking so much time to practice and prepare for this event. And thank you, everybody at home, for tuning in. The more people that tune in to these matches, the more you can count on seeing in the future. The first map being Katrina, this can be a pretty tricky map for Protoss. Your main is very large. You normally do see the Protoss go for the Fast Nexus on this map. We have seen variations of that, maybe a one gateway rush followed up by the Fast Nexus. But we'll see exactly what Shuttle has prepared for this. Cheers to all of the community sites out there that have been supporting us, StarCraft and non-StarCraft. We've been surprised to see how many different websites and forums and blogs have been talking about this event, not just ones that are focused primarily on gaming. So cheers to you guys. I hope you enjoy these games. I know I'm very pumped to be casting them. We did see Jadong annihilate Lomo in his best of three. Looked like Lomo was going to win in the final game, and then Jadong just came and destroyed him. It was ridiculous. I have not seen domination like that in a while. Definitely check it out. We save all of these recordings on the GOM TV site, www.gomtv.net. GOMTV.com is the Korean version if you are interested in seeing the games announced in Korean. Well, a lot of people believe that Jadong's going to come out with a win, but I've been talking to Shuttle's coach, and he says that he's actually very confident that Shuttle can perform excellently in this series and maybe even come out with a win. And if Shuttle defeats Jadong, it will be huge. Jadong, the best Zerg in the world, it's going to be tough to take on a player such as him. Jadong is known for being able to get away with just about anything, sir. He can do these fast, aggressive micro builds. He can throw in the psychology, mix you up with some of his crazy strategy, or he can simply dominate the map and outproduce you. Either way, though, we have to give it to Shuttle for making it this far. If he can take down the Goliath that is Jadong, well, the world will be impressed. The players have just entered their booths. I know that they did get the opportunity to test out their equipment beforehand. StarCraft, the most competitive and challenging esport out there. You need to bring your own keyboard. You want to have your own mouse pad. You want to know exactly what height your chair is for when you practice at home. This is a game that requires at least 200 actions a minute minimum. The professional gamers, for instance, Jaedong, I know, has clocked in and sometimes even up to 450. So in other words, if you're going to play that fast, you have to make sure everything is working exactly like it is when you train at home. Otherwise, you're going to miscontrol something. You're not going to be able to produce your units as quickly. And all of that is critical. They have both joined the game now. Wishing each other good luck. Our referee has joined, and our observers are ready. I would say maybe two or three more minutes, and we will have this game going. Now, one thing about Shuttle, I shouldn't just say Shuttle, for the entire matchup with Protoss versus Zerg, it's one of those matchups where really the burden for Protoss is to figure out when to attack. Zerg just keeps taking the map and harassing the opposing player. Here's Shuttle. As you can see, he's been playing a lot. He does have StarCraft back. That is what you call bad posture, but he's got some good Protoss to make up for it. And we are seeing some of his previous accomplishments. Now he's gone 10-0 in this tournament. He's been untouched. And there he is, smiling in his booth. But will he be smiling for long? And here, of course, is Jaedong, who has, by the way, a mob of fans down here. That's okay, though. We do have we have bouncers to protect the pro gamers from the fangirls. Oh, they could be bossers if the fangirls got aggressive. Well, this is a big day for both of these professional gamers. Jaedong may be one step away from making it to the finals, or he may be about to lose in a huge upset to this brand new player, Shuttle, the player who has been undefeated. The quality of the games at this tournament have just been getting better and better as the tournament has progressed. You can see Shuttle calming himself. He may be able to beat Jaedong, but he has to make sure he's calm and composed when he's in the game, when it's all started up. We do have a pretty even race distribution. We have one Zerg, one Terran, and two Protosses. Really goes to show you what a balanced game StarCraft is.
꽃피는 4월에 시작했던 TG3보 인텔 클래식. 8강 진출자 중 유일한 B시드자였던 김현중. 파란에 파란을 곱하기하며 4강까지 진출. 이런 그를 아직도 득보잡이라고 하는 사람이 과연 있을까?
프로게이머 김현중 누구냐고 물어보면 아는 사람? 몇 명 될까요?
벗어나면 되니까 괜찮습니다.
하지만 이러한 그가 일을 박박 가는 사람이 하나 있으리. 자신의 시변성을 저지시키며 1패라는 오점을 남기 위한 이선수인 것이다.
박지수입니다.
제 웃음 저지한 거 평생 기억하겠습니다.
아, 솔직히 뭐 이재동, 뭐 이영호 이런 선수들 스케줄 너무 많잖아요. 하루 일주일에 몇 개씩 하고 정말 너무 많이 하고 있는데 김윤중 선수는 사실 다른 데서 제가 거의 본 적이 없거든요.
문득 박지수의 영혼이 들어간 듯 감정이입을 하는 최종원 해설. 어쨌든 일제히 박지수의 승리를 예상한 가운데 김윤중의 4강행을 예지한 자가 있었으니 일명 오작수로 통하는 고영준 기자다.
장사 한두 해 하는 것도 아니고요. 이 정도 기본 아니겠습니까? 건 좋겠어.
고기장님 공부 잘 쓰시고 대성도 잘 하시고 참 훌륭하신 분 같아요.
좋게 맞춤을 가지고 너무 잘하시는데
문제는 그게 아니다. 김인중에게 이를 가는 또 한 명의 선수가 있었으니
박지수 선수의 복수까지 해드릴게요.
이재동이라면 가능하다. 저그의 암흑기 중에도 승승장구하고 있는 저그의 구수주가 아닌가.
저그의 구세주는 수신 박성준 선수.
솔직히 저그가 아무리다 아무리다 이렇게 우는 소리 하는 사람인데 기술적으로 오버하는 경향이 있는 거 아닙니까?
서운합니다 정말.
서운할 만도 하다. 요즘 이보다 더 잘하는 선수가 어디 있다고 그러는가 말이다.
왜요? 뭐 이용호 선수 있잖아요.
그런 말에 기들었을 것 같으면 옛날에 좋았다.
곧 1위 타락 다시 합니다.
힘들지 않을까 싶네요.
해설이나 잘하세요.
그렇다. 선수는 경기를, 해설자는 해설을 잘하자고 다짐하면서 마지막으로 두 선수의 각오를 들어보자.
루카포즈 절대 우습게 보시면 안 되고
제가 루카포 킬러라는 걸 보여드리겠습니다.
과연 그럴까요?
이력 플래시의 신데렐라로 떠오른 STX 소울 김현중. 저그의 희망자 루카포즈의 등불인 루카포즈 이재동.
Shuttle at the left side of the map, and at the top is Data. Jadong is going to be a little bit more susceptible to drops in this position, although fortunately enough, he is sending his Overlord in the correct direction. Now let's see how Shuttle opens up this game. He can either play passively or aggressively. Aggressively would be to make the one gateway and rush with Zealots one by one while expanding quickly with a Nexus to the back of his base, to play defensively with to go for the Nexus first or the Forge first. And as you can see, our predictions at the bottom are kind of one-sided. Jadong's opening up with a pretty early pull rather than going for the fast hatchery. Jadong deciding that if he could take control of the game early on, he could probably steer Shuttle to a loss. Nine pool. Jadong really likes this build. Basically, he gets the Zergling speed upgrade, takes out any scouting units, and then you have no intelligence as far as what the opposing player is doing until you get the Corsair out. This puts Protoss on the defensive. The Protoss has to at least prepare for all possible rushes. But at the same time, if the Zerg doesn't opt for anything aggressive, the Protoss may have wasted too many resources on defense. Forge first. And Shuttle still hasn't spotted his opponent. No, excuse me, now he is. Now he's keeping this probe alive for a little while, but Jadong's not going to let him get back in. Although, bear in mind, right off the bat, if you look on the mini-map at the middle right, Shuttle's already hidden an extra probe just in case. Now this is very good because it means that Shuttle's going to be able to scout his opponent and get a better idea of what's going on before he gets the Corsair out. Here come the Zerglings. Note the positioning of the gateway does create somewhat of a wall. There's some Jadong fans. She has also built a wall with that sign, just as Shuttle has built a wall with that gateway and forge. And you can see that Shuttle's just stopped him from making that hatchery. Just trying to buy some time. And he can see that, in fact, Jadong is going to play pretty passively. He was probably hoping to trap shuttle in his base, not suspecting that there would be an extra probe out there. That would, of course, maybe force shuttle into this position where he would be uncomfortable and play very defensively, probably overly defensively, knowing that he's against Jadong. So right now, Jadong's plan's not quite going as he probably would have liked. Meanwhile, shuttle doing a pretty standard tech. So right now, shuttle's playing pretty well. You can also see Jadong didn't get Zergling speed, so this entire opener was basically a fake to intimidate his opponent into playing defensively, as I've already said. But the fact that he didn't get that Zergling speed means that now shuttle's probe can roam freely and continue to scout. Maybe not for long, though. That probe must have been tired from running. He just gave up. Another probe sent out, though. And the Stargate is on the way. The Overlord has spotted it and is retreating. Overlords do not get along with Corsairs. And Aspire is Jadong's answer to that. Here comes Shuttle once again. I'm wondering if Jadong is really regretting not getting that Zergling speed. Although it looks like it's going to be impossible for Shuttle to get up into the main. Plus one attack on the way. So we're probably not going to see Corsair Reaver here. Probably Corsair and then tech to the standard Protoss army of Zealots, High Templar, etc. Well, clearly Shuttle isn't too nervous or flustered, because he's certainly doing a good job of microing his scouting probe and certainly scouting in locations to try to gain intelligence. He's aware that he can't get up into the main. Jadong massing up a lot of hatcheries. Here come the Mutas morphing now. And I guess the Stargate is closed. I don't see a Corsair being produced. Maybe Shuttle forgot a pylon. Oh, no, there it is. Excuse me. I thought it would have been a while. Now, he scouted the main, so he knows exactly what's up. Uh-oh. Scourge on the way. Uh-oh. This Corsair is in the no-fly zone. But he has to get some information. He wants to get just a little bit more intel. Here comes the Scourge. Don't want to lose that first Corsair. Zerg pretty much gain air control. Oh, God. He's got to get out of there. He might be able to make it back. There's another Scourge already waiting. One more. And it lives. He can regenerate most of that back with the shields. Again, pretty standard build here for the Protoss, but certainly a strong build at that. Apparently we have red posters now. We actually supply all the material to make all those signs, because we're so manner at GOM. I can't believe, all right, he's really scouting aggressively here. Blisks. They're out here, and these Mutalisks fended. You can suddenly see that Shelly thought that Jadong wasn't going to make any more Mutalisks, only seeing this, and it's now in it. And Jadong's Mutalisks have no mercy. One Archon is out, but good Mutalisk micro doesn't make the call. He has to rescue that location. All of his critical tech structures are there. The Robo Bay, the Templar Archives. You can see Jadong's being pretty cautious in this location at the bottom, though. Now backing out, surprisingly. I'm surprised he didn't at least harass the Nexus or the Templar Archives. And it looks like he was hoping that most of his opponent's forces would be at the bottom now. He's got to control those Mutalisks, though. You can see Jadon was hoping that a shuttle would in fact move his entire army down so then he could go at the main. Jadon, a very clever Zerg. Now he's going to go back in for some more probe kills. If he can take out that Corsair, yes he can. It's going to be very difficult for Protoss to regain control of this region. You can see the Mutalisk's just too agile. And the Archon, while it can deal a lot of damage, can't quite catch up. Uh-oh. Oh, man. He's going to have a healthy contain now. I think this may be similar to the game we saw with Jadon against Lomo, where Jadon turned the map Katrina into Jadon's House of Horror. With Shuttle's gateway count reduced, it's going to be hard to muster up a sizable... Well, he does have a pretty good army, actually. Pretty big. He's going to break out, stop the Lurker Contain. Jadon may have extended himself. Oh, man, but he's morphing a lot of Lurkers. And there's no way that Zealots and High Templar and Archons can take that on. He's going to have to switch to the Dragoon Tech. And you can see the Hive's already just now started. You can see that Shuttle's probe count has been pretty greatly reduced. And Jadon is more than prepared for this offensive. So many Lurkers, keeping most of them in the back so that it looks like he has less. Maybe luring his enemy in there. And here comes the rest of them now. And there's just really nothing Shuttle can do. Jadon is going to turtle pretty hard right now and just pass up. Oh no, this is not what he should be doing. Shuttle's going to move in, but there may be just too many Lurkers and his entire army is going to disappear. Jadon looked like Houdini back there. He just made all those Zealots disappear. Well, now I don't know what Shuttle can do because his army is so small. Jadon has so much of the map and has free reign of the map as well. I assume Shuttle's going to try to expand now. And the Defiler Mount is on the way. That's never good. Well, never good if you're Protoss. No. Shuttle is really starting to fall apart this game. His army is so small. You can see Jadon has Zerglings everywhere on the map just to make sure that there aren't any hidden expansions. And even has that small Zergling force there so that if Shuttle decides to move out, Jadon will rush in there and take out the command center. I mean the Nexus command center. Sorry, guys. Well, because Shuttle is somewhat forced to make a lot of Dragoons, it looks like Jadon's now going to make a massive amount of Zerglings to nullify the use of those Dragoons. And here comes Shuttle moving out now. But this map is a dangerous place for Protoss to be wandering around on. And there's a counterattack over here! And there might be too many Zerglings going directly for the Nexus. No, but Shuttle barely holds it off. That was a big waste for Jadon. At least one thing's going Shuttle's way now. But I don't know if Shuttle can break this ramp over here. Tons of units in the Zerg base. Protoss starting to gain his ground a little bit, but Jadon's already exploiting at the top right.
Well, 이문경 선수도 좀 되지가 않는 상황입니다.
You can see though, Shuttle still playing very cautiously. He's now going to expand again to the mineral natural. I think Shuttle's concluded that there's really no way he can go anywhere on this map. Jadong is going to have Ultralis though very soon. He already has a massive amount of Zerglings and Lurkers, of course. Once he techs to the Ultralisks, he may start abusing Drop and Dark Swarm. Uh-oh, and it looks like Jadong's going to do another counter, but this time he has Dark Swarm, so he can make those cannons useless. And this is what I think Shuttle should have done a while ago, is park over here on the low ground and storm these drones. But Jadong's already evacuated them. And it looks like he's actually going to go for the main, maybe? No, he's not. Here's the Dark Swarm! Oh, but a nice storm, but I don't think it's going to be enough. Whoa! Barely, that last circling takes that Nexus down. That was very close. Well, now Shuttle's economy has been hurt even more. Jadong is playing very cautiously, though. He knows he's made it to the final four. He doesn't want to make any stupid moves. And you can see Jadong's defense is just perfect. There's just nothing that Shuttle can really do once Jadong got that advantage. So he's definitely confident he can pretty much wear his opponent down. Now, I don't know if this is a wise decision for Shuttle to be going up here. And I think he's aware of that now. He's at such a high risk of a counterattack. We're going to see a drop pretty soon. And as you can see, Shuttle is so far away from home right now. You can see he's trying to break in here. I think Jadong may have enough to take out both. Nice storm, though. The Archon will still be picked off. Pretty necessary to keep the Archons alive if you want to fight off the Zerglings. Meanwhile, massive drop about to happen at the bottom left. And it doesn't look like Shuttle's prepared to take that on. He does have one Dark Archon for feedback against the Filers. Oh, Shuttle's got to get out of there. He's already been plagued. Here comes that drop. And this is not good. Shuttle is about to lose this expansion down here. His tech structures as well, the Robo Bay and the Templar Archives. A counterattack about to happen over here. Jadong was just waiting for Shuttle to get uncomfortable and overstep himself. The Nexus is under heavy fire. This is not good for Shuttle. I don't think it's physically possible for him to win now, losing two Nexuses. Ultralisks out as well. This is just not good. If you're Protoss like me, it's not good. It's a sad day for IR right now. But who knows? Maybe Shuttle can come back. He does have, definitely not this game, but you know, maybe in the next series. I think this may be Shuttle's last attempt here. You see that Shuttle is pretty distracted. Not quite sending enough probes to the expansions that actually need to mine from. Yeah, and looks like Jadong's going to clean this mess up. GG! Game one goes to Jadong. That Stone Cold Killer. Well done, Jadong. You're already up 1-0. Can Jadong keep this ball rolling? We're going to go to game two here in just a little bit. Oh, I can see the camera over here. Shuttle's going to have to collect himself. That was a pretty poor game, I think, by him. It started out strong, but once those duelists got in there, there was just nothing that Shuttle could do. Had he been more prepared, we may have seen a different game. Shuttle was not playing terribly, but once he lost his advantage, there was just very few options on his plate. Not to mention, Jadon, after he secured a few extra expansions, immediately entered a defensive mode, very different from what we saw with the Lomo versus Jadon game. Jadon clearly capable of playing different styles here. Jadon, once he knew he had secured it, just wanted to really bulk up his chances of coming out with a win. And he just all he had to do was sit back and wait for Protoss to move, and then he could orchestrate a very complicated attack in multiple regions, and there was just nothing that Shuttle could do with such a small unit count. Well, the next map's going to be on Bluestorm. Both players are in the game, so our Korean commentators, whenever they're ready, we will get this started. I hope you're enjoying these games. That last one was pretty exciting, very technical play by Jadon. Oh, and also, get this, on a completely unrelated note, I just found out last week that there is a WoW pro team called Nick Plod Fan Club. That is so manner. I am sponsoring you guys with beer if we ever meet. You heard it here. I think, by the way, definitely check out our WoW tournament that we've been hosting, the K-Swiss WoW tournament. Definitely take a look at that and expect more gaming tournaments from GUM in the future. Thanks to our baller sponsors. Well, the next map, as I said, Bluestorm, it's one of these maps where Protoss is pretty much required to fast expand or to do an all-in rush. You really can't get away with anything else due to the architecture of it. Fast expand is arguably, well, at least debatably, the strongest Protoss versus Zerg opener, and probably the most common that we see nowadays. In the old school days, back when I was a young noob, it was mostly one gate and two gate builds, and then you slowly expanded. But now the whole game has changed. Looks like we're going to get this going. Game two. Jadon and Shuttle, the number one Zerg against the number one new player, Shuttle. Let's get ready.